Right, time for some brakes on my Renault Trafic Mark 1. Not a how-to video, this is a tell me what I'm doing wrong video. So I hope it helps somebody out anyway. Right, brakes, one side done. So I thought it might be helpful for somebody to learn from my cock-ups. And once you've done one, second one's always quicker. Well, might be always quicker. Bigger bar. Okay, jacked up. With an axle stand. Now I'm replacing the caliper, so I've got to try and undo these pipes. And these nuts are pretty small and flimsy at the best of time. Oh, that one's cracked easy enough. That one's been a bit more difficult. Don't move the camera, it's in the way. Right, well I've cracked that one. But as you can see, when I move the bolt, or move the nut, it moves the pipe. So that pipe's stuck to the end of that nut, which you don't want. So a bit of wriggle, hopefully it will break free. Just keep turning, you're going to bust the end of the pipe off. Right, so now it's these little clips here. Well, that didn't take much getting out. And one underneath. That was good, the bottom one was missing. someone out now. Right, in my case then, I've got one loose pipe and one fixed. So I'm just going to crack that fixed one while the caliper's still on. Try and crack it. There we go. Now what? I think the caliper will come out with it. And now I can undo that fixed one by turning the caliper. Bit of a bodge way of doing it, but should be alright. Now on the other side, there's some little springs down here, anti-rattle springs, and on the other side, they're at the top. Does that make a difference, I wonder? Oh, those are horrible, aren't they? Okay. And this was disconnected on the other side. I've got new ones with the kit. I'll just leave that for a bit. So, now I've got to take out the two Allen key bolts here. Right, back to it. Most of my time is looking for tools. So, I'm going to give these bolts a bit of a clean out. Now I've got one of these Allen key bolts. Don't even try with one of those L-shaped bolt things. I don't think you get any way with one of those because these are pretty tight. that gate has finally split open. That's been mentioned on several MOTs, and it's never been done. Second one coming out. Ready to go on. Not a restoration, just shows that I've been here. And it's good to get all that crud off stuff you're dropping in your new brakes. Okay, let's get these off. A bar in there just to wedge it. This is an 8mm. You get the idea. Alright, undo this nut. That same pull, give this a bit of a whack to free it off the spline. On the other side, I didn't really need to do that, I don't think. Anyway, two M10 80mm bolts. Ah, it's starting to rain. It's supposed to be nice today. Sort of feel when that bottoms out. Anyway, rain is going to stop play for a bit, I think. Right, where were we? Cup of tea later. That noise you can hear, they're putting scaffolding up across the road. Put that bar back in there. Can we get that in somewhere? I'm not sure we've even bottomed out yet. Maybe that one has. hanging on. I'm sure it said in the book, put some Loctite on these. Is that Loctite? Or is it hardened grease? Can't tell really. It's pretty dry in there. So a little bit of extra grease won't hurt. Right, now I need to change that gaiter. So I'm guessing a bit here, but I suspect we have to undo the track rod end and split this joint here at the bottom of this assembly. So that's 17mm, that's 24mm. Let's see what happens.
Do the easy one first then. Easy enough. Put that back on there, we don't need it. Now this one. I'll edit that out, see.
I'm just going to push that up a bit. Yeah. Get this higher. I don't want to split that boot. That's as high as it can go with, it's been a bang now. Resorts on these pickle forks, which I hate them things. They always seem to damage the gator, but better luck we've got away with that. Thank you.
they can just look easy, aren't they? Try something else. And we're free. I had to undo this this drop link to the anti-roll bar. And there we are. So I don't have a gaiter yet. I'm gonna have to order one. Just cut that off and have a look at it. This rubber is absolutely welded. Welded to that. That's it for today. I've ordered gaiter. I make this 88 and the shaft 28. And I know that the caliper bracket bolts are Loctited, and I found that these were Loctited as well. But do people Loctite this? Seems a bit odd to Loctite a spline shaft, but I think that's what the book says. I'd say I didn't on the other side. One other anomaly. I found on this side that these little clips are on the bottom. On the other side, they're on the top. I doubt that makes a lot of difference. But anyway, to be continued.